I am Chadiwa Sinoya. I am Africa.
Good thing anyway, because we're also given freedom of choice by God, but then it becomes a problem when all of us around here are making the decision and the choice to actually not look African. Am I wrong? How many of you would like to walk around there and be called African? Don't just lie to me right now. Raise your hands. Liars. Anyway, so I think today what we're about to do is what this day is all about. What inspired this day is to bring about every African that's there. You're not all of them anyway, but anyway. All of the Africans that are there, then you bring about what you think is African to you, okay? I think as a generation, we don't realize what it means to be African, what it is to be African, and how proud we should be, or we don't know much about being African. So we'd like to invite all of you, different people from different places, to come upstage, show us what you have, and then you interpret to us what it is to be African for you. Because after all, today is called TiriAfrica anyway. So I'd like to welcome each and every one of you here. I'd like you to have a great time. We have a whole lot of performances lined up for you, and great artists, and we also have special guests who we work with, under our auntie, our dearest ambassador. So I'd like to thank you and welcome. I hope you have a good day. Thank you.
There's always going to be a ball inside.
Yes, there is a ball here.
My name is Father Ignatius and I am the Young People Father's spiritual advisor. I am Africa.
The coolest dancer in this country. Give a round of applause to my co-MC, John Cole.
Hello, how y'all doing?
About the concert, I said that we are here planning for the TiriAfrica concert. Like I said, we've realized that we are working with people. We want to build holistic beings, people who are full, right? So this concert was after us realizing that there's a lot of cultural disintegration that's happening. People are losing the values, the morals, and kind of turning into Western kind of, not that that's a bad thing, but for it's because of our identity. We need to identify ourselves as Africans.
We've lost that realization of who we are as Africans, what it actually means.
Well, what's your version?
What it means to be African. Yeah. That's the thing we're trying to build in people, okay? Like they say, we don't know what it is to be African ourselves, okay? So we're actually trying to bring other Africans, you know? Probably. If we could actually bring people from different continents and all that. Luckily, this time we're doing it at Arabic College, which means there are other people from different countries in Africa and all that. So I think we're trying to realize what it means to be African, who we are as Africans, and we have to build that inner pride, you know? Of being African. It's a bad thing that everything they were trying to do as a generation now is trying to avoid being African. We're trying to look less African. So trying to build people and show them, no, it's okay to be African. You have to be proud of where you come.
Is it about skin color or culture or something?
That's the thing where you get lost. Because, you know, you can't say being African is about color, it's about clothes, it's about technology, art or something like that. No. Obviously, if it's about color, then we have Tunisia, we have white people. Egypt, we have white people. They're African as well. South Africa is white people. They're African as well. And it's not about color, you know. There's something deep about being African, and then we're trying to identify that. So this concert,
so
I think.
You think this concert will also bring about different cultures, different ideas of young people, what their vision or thought of what Africa is?
Yeah, I think so. I think it'll bring up what people think. You come with a presentation, then you show us what it is to be African for you. Okay, and then put that all together at the end of the day. We now know what it is to be, you know, TiriAfrica. You know?
And if you look at the name, TiriAfrica, literally translates to we are Africa. So it's a declaration of identity. We are declaring who we are to the world. We are Africa. And the presentations that we're going to have, they're just going to show other people what it means to be African, you know? So there's no format to being an African. It's really just a matter of declaring that I am an African, and that's why we have this concert, so that people can come on stage, do whatever they want, and after they're done with whatever they're doing, they can declare that I am an African. I am an African.
When I say Africa, you say? TiriAfrica. When I say TiriAfrica, you say Africa.
TiriAfrica.
TiriAfrica.
Africa.
Are you Africa?
We are Africans. We are a people of untimed rhythm, jagged heartbeats, and the clapping of the sun. We are the gods and the nations of the sea, the rattling of the seductions of the sun. The storm you feel brewing inside me.
The flash of the stars at night.
We are the celebration and the vibration of the loud together drum. The silent hum of a river without the need of a warranted occasion.
For the Appreciate it. I hate the spirit of patriotism, which requires a touch of youthful innovation, what you have been doing. Because when you celebrate Africa, we are celebrating our continent, our people, our resources, our cultures, our food, and then don't lose your creativity. So please carry on with that, your innovation and future.
Gender activist. My poem, my first poem, is entitled Brave. I am not afraid of creepy, crawly spiders or love. I am not afraid of being a woman, of being lonely, or not fitting into your perceptions, not afraid of my own reflection. There is method in my insanity and practice in these jazz symphonies I live each day. And somewhere in there, there is poetic outburst there. So you call me painter, painting my own Picassos each day, nursing rainbow colors of my soul on these pages with my pen stroke. There are golden reflective surfaces that cover the surface, and have you seen behind my mask? I'm pulling Shakespearean tricks to remind you that I am bigger than here now. See, I am perfect, but not in the branded, commercialized, socialized, standardized measure of whatever. I am beautiful, white lily, ebony skin, dream woven in poetry in motion. I am flower bed of impatience, cocooned in silk fabrics of journal pages, and I stand tall behind these truths. I'm seeking broken fragments of me, mending them with the tapestry of this poetry. So when they ask you, and they will, who's that girl? Tell them it's Ray Lyric, woman of bravery, of tenacity, of integrity by my own standards, not just two arms, booty, and boobs. I am brains. I am the intellect of my grandmother's pearls of wisdom, and I picked up that hearts don't break evenly, but hearts do break easily. So yes, I will write my own rules. I script them beautiful as midnight, summer, full moon, scripted to my time. And it takes way more than sticks and stone-cold words to see me cry. Way more than being bruised by your ego. More than empty words to break the spirit. So I won't hide my voice. Don't shy my eyes. Cool, calm, and collected between these bones. This is my stadium. Every time I pick up my pen, I put on my show clothes. It's fit to be a show. I'm dancing to the rhythms of memoirs of strong women. I am the king of my queendom. I am dreaming, insomniac, creating, and scripting these pages and the world's pages too.
Thank you. bloodline. So I'm gonna show you how to dance when we're in Hawaii. And then I'm gonna ask you guys to join me. Are you gonna join me? Because I'm shy. If you're gonna join me, please come to the front and join me. Let's go. Ale.
But then, that's the nature of the path they chose. Everyone is busy earning a living to the extent that no one cares to build a life. I see the learned husband slapping the illiterate wife. Oh yes, I see the learned wife pouring insults on the illiterate husband. No one seems to care what the naked and ashamed insatiable craving for the Western life has done. I want to say this out. I do. But then I'm just a student. My knowledge is bound to play within the parameters of the vowels and the number line. Oh yes, there was a time when manhood was shown on the battlefield, the maize field and the hunting ground. Behold, what sort of manhood is this, shown by knocking behind each and every female of each and every crow. The girl child's decency has been turned into a highway, and boys come at breakneck speed. Only God knows how many men she works in the night and divorce in the morning. A honeymoon with no honey, just a moon. Where is the Africanness in the African child? The time when virginity made a store of dignity until the right opportunity. Now, virginity is no longer dignity, but rather a lack of opportunity. I want to say this out. I do. But then I'm just a student. My knowledge is bound to stay within the parameters of the vowels and... But no. I said no, the absurdity of it all prickles the deeper fibers of my nature. My stomach grows with the fear of the unknown, my mind strikes a pose. I choose to stand and speak for the bush. I refuse to rely on the weather report for the temperature in my own blanket. How can I stand and be silent when you're manufacturing black men with a white brain? Men whose manhood has been crushed in the tight pants they wear, their eyes blinded by the chaff from Western soapies and movies. If this is the modern life you choose, then it's too modern for me. I refuse to be a learned but corrupt citizen, to be amongst those of cold and timid souls and people compelled by greed and selfishness. If only the world had a reset button. I refuse to be part of a society that calls potato chips French fries even when they are made from Zimbabwean potatoes. If this is the modern life you choose, then it's too modern for me. Better were the days when scrappy happiness used to be the song of the day. I know just a student, my knowledge is bound to play within the parameters of the vowels and the number line, but until your manhood recuperates, I'll go on and turn this insult into a national anthem. Then I'll go on to act, work and sweat. Act, work and sweat like the man, the African that I think you should also be. Thank you.
James, and I am Amara Brown. I'm
Keep that space open, but come to this side of the